Welcome to Banking Frontiers Live. We are in for a very, very deep conversation in the area of compliance and this time into the securities market. And with me today, I have an interesting guest who is heading compliance and legal at Yes Securities. And his name is Aditya Goenka. Aditya is going to share with us some very interesting perspectives of the changing realms in the area of compliance from what it used to be in a world which is totally digital. Aditya, welcome to Banking Frontiers Live.
Thank you so much. Pleasure to be a part of this interview.
So Aditya, you have been a professional into legal and compliance. And how has the landscape of this entire function of compliance and legal changed in the last few years, especially in the wake of all these regulations around data privacy and various other things coming out, the digital world taking a real fast movement in the financial sector?
The evolution in the industry, we all have acknowledged and seen the evolution right from the beginning till date, from a town hall to a digitalized stock exchanges that has happened in 1992. And with the evolution and the main evolution that has happened post-pandemic, the kind of regulations that has come up and the kind of technology that has come up, the investors, the ease of doing business that has been come up and the information that is required to be get it passed on to the client, the transparency basically that we can talk about is much, much more this thing nowadays. So that kind of implementation and the guiding force that is behind our SEBI chairperson is tremendous. Like in India is always being, NSE is awarded as one of the best derivative exchanges from last so many years. So this showcases the kind of things that we were used to, you know, we have learned many things from the Chicago Mercantile Exchange. That is the parent, you can say, everything, the derivatives that we have learned, but we have gone beyond that. Still, a lot of things are there to, you know, implement in this area. But yes, at the same time, India journey is being tremendous and we are doing very good in this line.
And with stock exchange roaring to new heights every day to day and digital playing an equally important role in this roar of the short stock market, I'm sure the challenges must also be very, very high for a compliance person like you, because you may not know which day the gun is going to be on the head of the compliance guy. So what kind of challenges do you face?
Whenever in the organization, I'm a pro business person. We understand the business and I've grown up into a business family. So I've seen that what kind of a business flavors are there. But yes, as far as the compliances and the regulations are coming up, it is something very good to have in our company and in the overall this thing, because the transparency, some way or the other, the way regulators are coming up, they are favoring to us, I will say. Because some way or the other, you can take it in a two different ways. Either you can take it, you know, it's something that I don't want to follow. It is not allowing us to do the business. Or you can take it in a positive way. So the kind of regulations that are coming up, it is helping some way or the other to the client as well and to the broker as well. But yes, at the same time, the events that has happened in the past because of which, you know, certain things are there because we are reluctant to the change. But at the same time, when changes is required, then it becomes very difficult to adopt that. And with the new transformation that has happened, what I have learned is be very quick in unlearning the things. Learning new things, definitely we all love to learn new things. But with time, you have to know and understand the importance of unlearning the old things. Unless and until you will not learn to unfold the old things, unlearn the old things, you will never be able to learn new things, because that will stop you to do something new. Your mindset up will not going to be get it changed. That is absolutely very important that you need to learn that.
Absolutely. You need to refresh your hard disk before you load the new data.
Yes.
Along with that, today is an age of fintech, and everyone is getting into wealth management, or fintechs have really come up into a big way. And at the same time, whenever there is an innovation, of course, the compliance is the biggest hurdle that they have to cross. How have you been balancing innovation and compliance put together?
See, I always, what I say to my entire business friends and colleagues, I will just repeat the same thing. They always feel that compliance is their enemy. I always try to maintain a very friendly relationship with all the business guys, whoever I've worked in my entire 2 decades of career. And I always say one thing. Boss, there is a very simple thing in the life. It's your choice where you want to drive your business. Because earning too fast is not important. I will not name the company, but we have seen recently the big player in the market who has wiped out overnight. With the single statement of a regulator, the entire company, the entire enterprises, the entire business model is on a stake. And it's almost finished now. We don't know what regulator RBI will going to come up with, but yes. So it's totally up to you. It's your kitty, it's your business, it's your baby. How you want to make things happen. But yeah, at the same time, I always try to give the breathing space to them as well. If it is a gray area, make sure your intentions are very clear. Because recently when I have got an opportunity to meet the SEBI chairperson as well as the GM in the RBI because of some work, so they are very profound in their knowledge. This is a very simple thing for a matter that I have gone for. Kilo karate, we understand that you are what you are trying to say. Take care. So that disclaimer is there. Whenever we launch anything or we see anything, there's a small disclaimer which is very miniaturely written in the document, and it's a too long. And in that disclaimer, we try to cover up everything. Right? She has said only a simple line. Nobody reads this. Nobody reads this, and we all know this. So don't try to showcase me that as a disclaimer, you have put it everything transparently and you have informed to the client. What we are looking for is how you are showcasing your product.
Correct.
That is where the transparency comes into the picture. It's not about that you have given the disclaimer and you are doing everything. The way you are presenting, your intentions, if your intention is not wrong, I will make sure Aditya, we will not going to penalize you.
Super. And with so much of regulatory changes day by day, it is not easy to keep track as a compliance head also, whatever you are, to keep so much in pace with the kind of changes that is happening. So what is your formula of getting the right kind of compliance at the right point in time and ensure that you are staying abreast?
The basic concept about any regulation plays a very important role. Recently, we have gone through a SEBI inspection also. And that, you know, we had an inspection for 2 years kind of a thing, horizon. So a lot of changes that has happened related to the regulatory reporting and all. The basic concept is very much important. Deep understanding related to the operations is very much important for any compliance person. I have never faced any problem in my career as a compliance guy, to be very honest. I'm blessed with few of the very good business guys who has always supported to me. Over here also, our MD is very supportive. The sales head, Mr. Mathur, is very supportive, and they understand and they truly admire key. Yes. Why? Because I always say one thing, because compliance is important, but it should not be at the cost of business also. And business should also think in the same way, that it should not be at the cost of compliance. Because the regulations nowadays, we are blessed with few of the good circulars, to be very honest. If you will see the circulars of 2 years back, lot of ambiguity was there. Lot of gray area was there. Lot of misinterpretations has happened. And when we go to the exchange to seek the clarification, they are also unable to give, because it is from how they, because ultimately So everybody tries to rephrase themselves not to comment on anything. But yes, your intentions, your deep understanding that why these regulations have come up. What is the intention behind a regulator bringing up this new regulation? That is need to be understand. If you have understand the crux of that, it's nowhere difficult to implement it.
Superb. How do you see role of some of these forward-looking technologies? Everyone talk. There is no company which is not talking about AI or machine learning, especially. So, which of these things you see very promising for your business, and especially from the compliance perspective and the projects perspective?
I personally believe that no technology will ever able to replace the human feel and the intervention and the kind of analytics that we use. Some way or the other, machine plays a very important role. The new kind of AI that has come up, it has made our life easy. But yes, at the same time, we need to understand that how well-versed we are to utilize that AI. When we utilize something, we should know how promisingly we can utilize and how we can make things easier for our client. It is easy to implement anything at any given point of time, but the repercussion of that also needs to be understood. 100%, 100% depending on the technology will never going to help you out in the future. Because when we also do a lot of meetings like this, we are having an interview kind of a thing. But the in-person things, when we interact, go to a client or to a regulator to meet in person, the kind of comfort with which they talk is very different. Technology will help us in making things easier, understanding the analytics, taking the background of the, the past historical data. It becomes easier to get it on a single click. So you're working on that part has become very easy. But implementing the same in the right fashion and creating the best product out of it plays a very important role. And that only a human can understand the need of another human.
Absolutely. And what does it actually, since you have so many people within the organization, on one side the business, on one side operations, one side compliance, what does it take to be business strategy friendly at the same time a strong culture of compliance if you want to build it in the organization? What does it take?
Building the confidence. Your approach should be friendly. Having a friendly approach doesn't mean that you will do something non-compliance or you will allow something to do non-compliance. You should be accessible. Saying things straightforwardly, no, is very easy. But understanding the
Why it is
pain
not
that a
possible.
person is feeling, because a person who is being into sales, they are also having some targets. Some way or the other, they also need to be get it achieved. Making them understanding the importance. Whenever I go to meet any regulator or attend any conference, whatever the brief that notes that I've taken, I always try to draft a, the minutes of that, share with my internal stakeholders, because this is the thing, this is what we are doing, this is what, industry is doing. How we can collaborate, how we can make things happen. So going out and meeting is the person I am doing. But I'm helping my entire stakeholders to take the note of the meetings that I have done outside. So the informal things that always helps.
Interesting. And if I may ask you, as a accomplished compliance officer, what is your two-liner to the compliance heads of the future?
First, understand operations in detail. The entire processing of the data or the regulations depends upon the operation activity. So, in operations of any organization plays a very, very important role. If you really want to have a very detailed understanding and want to be a very good in compliance, you should know what is happening at the ground level. Right from the KYC onboarding till the contract note dispatch, the entire process, the margins, files, the you know, the processing of the data, what kind of files that we receive, how many files that is there, what is the processing, because operations basically make sense. If you have a detailed understanding, you can easily understand what is there in the regulation. And that helps you to deliver within and outside the organization.
Great. I think we have had a wonderful conversation. Thank you very much for such a wonderful conversation. And we look forward to more such wonderful, delightful conversations with you in the future. Thank you, Aditya.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Pleasure to be here.